Now this can get even more complicated on really difficult u-substitution problems. Remember, our goal is to change all the x's to u's, and the dx needs to change to a du. This problem looks kind of similar to a previous problem that we did, the x squared over x cubed plus 1, but now we have an x to the fifth on top. So can we do the same at substitution we did before? We're going to do a process called back substitution to make that work. So we're going to use u equals x cubed plus 1, then du is 3x squared dx, just like before. And now I'm going to rewrite my integral because I need an x squared dx. Remember last time we put the 3 on the other side, so we can do that again. That 3 is not a big deal. But the x squared dx, that is a big deal. We need that. We need to be able to take an x squared dx and turn it into something with du's in it, so du over 3. The way we're going to do this is we're going to notice that on top of my integral, I have an x to the fifth. Well, I can rewrite x to the fifth as x to the third times x squared. So x to the third times x squared is x to the fifth. So I've rewritten my equation, but I've done it in such a way that I've pulled out an x squared dx that I can now substitute with the matching x squared dx over here in my list of ways I can replace x's with u's. So this becomes now du over 3. And the x cubed plus 1 on the bottom of the fraction, that's exactly what I called u. But now I have a problem. I have an x cubed left on top. So how do I fix this x cubed? Well, I need some way to turn that into u's. And the only thing I have to use is I have my original equation, u equals x cubed plus 1, or I have my du equation. But I can't use my du equation because it has a dx in it. I've already used the dx. So I have to use this u equals x cubed plus 1. Is there any way I can figure out what x cubed is equal to in terms of u? Yeah, I can. I can solve this equation for x cubed. Get x cubed equals u minus 1. So I can replace this x cubed with a u minus 1. And my new integral then is the integral of u minus 1 divided by u times du over 3. This technique right here of solving for some kind of x and putting it back into the problem, this is what we call back substitution. All right, so now we have the integral u minus 1 over u du over 3. We need to simplify this algebraically so that we can actually find its antiderivative. We pull the 1/3 out front, and now we're going to split up u minus 1 over u into two fractions, u over u minus 1 over u du, which I'm now going to split up into two different integrals. So I'm going to have 1/3 the integral of 1 du minus 1/3 the integral of 1 over u du. Each of these integrals I know how to do. So now we have 1/3 the integral of 1 du. Now this is a good question. Is this x or u? Because we have a du here, that means we're integrating in terms of u. U is our variable, so the integral of 1 is going to be u. Minus 1/3, again, the integral of 1 over u is natural log of the absolute value of u plus c. And then our last step is to go back to x's, so we use our u equals x cubed plus 1 to get 1/3 x cubed plus 1, make sure you put it in parentheses, minus 1/3 natural log of the absolute value of x cubed plus 1 plus c. And that's our final answer.